please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Call this meeting to order at 6 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Michael Cashman.
Present.
Thomas Wood.
I'm here.
Barbara Hebert.
Here.
Charles Kostick.
Here.
Dana Isabella.
Here.
James Coffey.
Here.
And Catherine Calucci is present.
Resolution 25, approve the minutes of the previous meeting.
Resolve that the minutes of December 16, 2021 be approved and the reading of minutes be dispensed with.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Kostick, any discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 So carries, thank you. Anything for public comment this evening? Seeing nothing for public comment, moving forward, Resolution 26, the abstract.
Resolve that the abstract of audited claims number 1B-22 for $182,352.14, abstract 1B-22A prepays for the amount of $166,042.10, and audited claims number 1B-2021 for $155,691.77 be received as reviewed by the audit committee, and the supervisor is hereby authorized to pay said abstract.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
I'm moving to Isabella. Any discussion? Seeing none, all those in favor, please say aye.
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 So carries. Resolution 27, monthly department reports.
Resolve to receive and place on file monthly department head reports. The Buildings and Grounds Department for December, Dock Control Officer not received. Highway Superintendent for December, Parks and Recreation for December, Safety Committee none, Tax Receiver none, Water, Wastewater for December, Code and Zoning for December, and year-end summary. Historian none, Justice Court none, Planning and Community Development none, Supervisory Report none, Town Clerk December.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostick, is there a second?
Second.
Wood. Any discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 So does carry. Thank you. Resolution 28, amendment of the host community agreement between the Town of Plattsburgh and Saranac Power Partners LP.
Whereas the Town of Plattsburgh and Saranac Power Partners LP entered into a host community agreement which was fully executed by the parties on January 11, 2018, said document is attached hereto and made part hereof. And whereas parties to said agreement desire to amend the agreement to extend its term, and whereas attached is a letter dated January 3rd, 2022 from John Gokey, Saranac General Manager, providing the rationale for the extension, as well as a copy of the First Amendment to the host community agreement. And whereas the town attorney, James Coffey, has carefully reviewed the document entitled First Amendment to Host Community Agreement. And whereas said amendment is in the best interest of the town of Plattsburgh, now therefore be it resolved that Michael Cashman, supervisor of the town of Plattsburgh, is hereby authorized to execute said First Amendment to Host Community Agreement.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Hebert, any discussion? None. Can I get a roll call, please?
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Kostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yes.
Michael Cashman?
Yes. Resolution does carry. Thank you. Resolution 29, annual examination of town fiscal records by the audit committee.
Whereas the town board is responsible for the general management and control of the town finances, town law, section 641. And important aspects of the responsibilities to provide a process to monitor and review on a routine basis the work performed by those who handle money as part of their town duties. And whereas in an effort to improve accountability and controls over finances and records, the Town of Plattsburgh Auditing Committee and Finance Manager has reviewed the 2020 records of the Town Clerk, Town Justices, Recreation, and Town Tax Receiver as per regulation. And whereas the Town Clerk, Town Justices, Recreation, and Town Tax Receiver's records have been provided to the full board for their review, and whereas a review of town records has been prepared and is hereby presented to the town board for their review and approval. Now therefore be it resolved that the annual audit as prepared and submitted by the Town of Plattsburgh Auditing Committee be accepted and placed on file as per regulation.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Ebert, is there a second?
Second.
Kostick, any discussion? Seeing none. All those in favor, please say aye. Recreation Director promotion of our entanglement.
Whereas a vacancy exists in the Town of Plattsburgh Recreation Department for a Youth Services and Recreation Director, and whereas Ms. Erin Pinkhorn has been recommended for the promotion to fill the vacant position in the Recreation Department, and whereas her qualifications have been reviewed by the County Department of Personnel, it has been determined appropriate, therefore be it resolved that the Town of Plattsburgh Town Board does hereby authorize a provisional promotion pending successful completion of Youth Services and Recreation Director examination. And be it further resolved, this promotion will take effect on January 30th, 2022, with a 12-week probationary period. This places Ms. Erin Pinkhorn at the step one and salary of $63,772.80. It is further resolved that the supervisor is hereby authorized to sign all necessary documents to promote Ms. Pinkhorn to the position of Youth Services and Recreation Director. Be it further resolved that a certified copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager and be placed in Ms. Pinkhorn's personnel file.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Kostick, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, discussion. Go ahead. I'd just like to start by saying that Erin has been a wonderful member of the Town of Plattsburgh team for a long time. And I think we're most fortunate to have her of service for all those years, but I think her leadership is going to do wonderful things for the town. She certainly has some big shoes to fill, but I think she will carve her own path as well. And just look forward to seeing what she provides in this new capacity. So I think she's very much looking forward to the new challenges and opportunities as well.
And I would just add that Dana and I had a great meeting with her last week, and her knowledge and understanding and ideas and where she wants to go, and you know, the collaboration is just, I think is going to be great. And like you said, Michael, tough shoes to fill. But I could stand corrected, but I believe that she's only going to be the fourth or
third. Yeah.
And of that, she'll be the second female to
Yeah.
the position.
But it's amazing with that position that there's only been three people. That's really amazing. So.
And wonderful programs, don't we?
Mm-hmm.
Great, unrivaled.
Tom, I didn't want to skip over you.
Oh, that's okay. I'd just like to say that since she started, I've never found her not to be very positive, accepting of everybody, trying to help people. Always with a smile on her face. I've come in many, many times when she's worked here, since she's worked here, and I just find that. The only question I had was it just an error that we put down the wrong level one, step one of the salary, and we had to, from last year, and that's why we put it, changed it?
Yeah, it was just a quick thing in the business office, so we made that amendment, yeah.
And Chuck, to add to your comments, Erin has also set the bar for some, certification, so we talked recently about her recent certification in the playground inspector, so, setting up the standard of the bar.
Just one point of reference for the resolution. Now, the first whereas,
yep,
is a vacancy exists. Is that okay? And that
it's,
the vacancy doesn't exist until
no, because it's based upon we've received the notice.
Okay,
it's a notice of vacancy. So just to talk a little bit more in the final details of it. So starting, I just want to find the date here. January 30th, that's when the changing of the guard, for lack of better terms, will begin. What that means is Erin will start to assume the roles and responsibilities, not only as the Youth Services Recreation Director, but she will also serve in the capacity as a department head. So, for example, we have a department head meeting every once in a while, so she'll start going in those things. And she will be involved with the Recreation Committee to identify who the replacement is for, her current role, for lack of better terms, as well. So, here we go. All right. Can I get a roll call, please?
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Robert Heber?
Yes.
Charles Kostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yeah.
Michael Cashman?
Yes. Resolution carries. Resolution 31, Cumberland 12, Cinemas License Application.
Whereas to comply with the Town of Plattsburgh Codes and Zoning Laws, Cumberland 12 Cinemas has applied for a license to conduct and operate a cinema known as Cumberland 12 Cinemas. Plattsburgh at 18 North Bowl Lane, Route 9. And whereas said application was applied for and received with a license fee of $500, and whereas the code department has completed their inspection and has found Cumberland 12 MOs to be in compliance with all local laws and New York State regulations and codes, therefore be resolved to receive and place on file an application for a license to conduct and operate Cumberland 12 cinemas. It is further resolved that the town clerk is hereby authorized to issue said license for the period from January 1st, 2022 through December 31st, 2022.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Fosdick, any discussion? Seeing none, all in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Resolution carries. Resolution 32, budget amendment.
Resolution 32, you said?
32.
Whereas the town may need to amend the 2021 budget to reflect changes in revenues and expenditures during the year. Therefore, whereas the budget amendments will be an offset from existing fund balance or additional revenues. Therefore, be it that the town board of the town of Plattsburgh authorized the following budget amendment as attached. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Foster, is there a second?
Second.
Hebert, any discussion?
Michael, I didn't get the attachment. This is our standard practice in the Hebert. This one, I can follow up with that, right?
All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So it is carried. Thank you. Resolution 33, professional railroad consulting services.
Whereas the town of Plattsburgh, in partnership with the American Legion, post 1619, is pursuing the development of a public waterfront area known as the Battlefield Memorial Gateway, located on New York State Route 9 South. And whereas the town has developed maps, plans, and schematic designs for the property, including the realignment and improvement of the existing crossing over the Delaware Hudson Mill lawn. And whereas the town has petitioned the commissioner of the New York State Department of Transportation for authorization to improve that crossing. And whereas the town requires specialized technical assistance for the negotiation, planning, and engineering of the new crossing. And whereas Saratoga Railroad Engineering, PC, with an address of 11 Rose Terrace, Saratoga Springs, New York, 12866, has been identified as a qualified consultant. And whereas Saratoga Railroad Engineering, PC, has provided a short form agreement and scope of services. And whereas the agreement and scope of services has been reviewed by the town attorney, determined to be valid and adequate. Now therefore be it resolved, the town of Plattsburgh Town Board does hereby accept the agreement and scope of services provided by Saratoga Railroad Engineering, PC, with an address of 11 Rose Terrace, Saratoga Springs, New York, 12866. It is further resolved that the supervisor is hereby authorized and directed to execute the agreements for said professional railroad engineering consulting services. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the finance manager and the planning and community development department.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Wood, is there a second?
Second.
Fosdick. Any discussion? This is just a continuation of the work that we're doing at the BMG. So this is, you know, that we had that public hearing a little while ago about the railroad crossing. Again, this is just by extension some of the work that we're doing over there. All those in favor, please say aye.
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 So does carry. Thank you very much. Resolution 34, services agreement between Mitchell Maggie and the town of Plattsburgh.
Whereas the town of Plattsburgh has entered into an agreement with the town of Ellenburg to provide attunement and interment services for the sum of $40 per attunement or interment. And whereas temporarily representatives of the town of Ellenburg are unable to perform such services, and whereas Mitchell Maggie has agreed to perform attunement services on behalf of the town for the sum of $400 for each interment, therefore be it resolved that after the town attorney's review, the supervisor be authorized to sign said agreement between Mitchell Maggie and the town to furnish and perform services which are the subject of the attached agreement.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Fosdick, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella, is there any discussion? I would just thank Jim and Katie for working on this. This really is a backup feature, like anything. We need to just be able to have that. We have the appropriate certificates of insurance, et cetera. So, you know.
He's a licensed funeral director as well.
So,
yeah.
And just, it addresses all the issues.
Yeah.
And it won't happen all the time, but it's really a backup situation.
Yeah.
So, all right. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
So does carry. Resolution 35, lead agent and secret review for 2022 former County Airport Smart Growth Plan Comprehensive Plan Amendment.
Whereas the town's existing comprehensive land use plan was authorized in 2010 and updated with the town center smart growth plan in 2021. And whereas it was determined that an update of the comprehensive plan specifically focused on the vacant approximately 500-acre former Clinton County Airport was necessary for the purposes of reducing sprawl, creating a unified development strategy, reducing energy consumption, providing for multimodal transportation, improving design guidelines, creating an authentic sense of place, and reducing greenhouse gas emissions. And whereas a public advisory committee, PAC, composed of residents, landowners, planning and zoning staff, the board, and board members, was instituted by the supervisor to assist in the planning update process. And whereas the public advisory committee has successfully developed a former Clinton County Airport smart growth plan update to the town's comprehensive plan. And whereas the public advisory committee has provided a final draft of the plan recommended for adoption by the town board of the town of Plattsburgh. And whereas after review and discussion of the proposed draft amendments, the town board desires to distribute the proposed document to the appropriate agencies in accordance with Article 17, Section 17.3 and 17.4 of the town's zoning ordinance and Section 264 and 265 of the New York town law as follows. 1, Clinton County Planning Board, 2, Town of Schuyler Falls, and 3, Town of Beekmantown, and 4, Town of Peru, and 5, Town of Saranac, and 6, City of Plattsburgh. And whereas New York town law requires that a public hearing on proposed amendments be held to consider the advisability of amendment to the town's Plattsburgh comprehensive plan. And whereas Part 617 of the Environmental Conservation Law, State Environmental Quality Review Act, Section 8-0113, SECRA herein, provides for the review of any action to determine the effect of said action to the environment, along with any related administrative procedures for the implementation, authorization, or approval of said action. And whereas Part 617-1 or .12b-2 of SECRA provides that the adoption of a municipality's comprehensive land use plan is a type 1 action. And whereas determination of the effect of said action on the environment will be necessary to determine whether a draft environmental impact statement is required. And whereas the Town of Plattsburgh Town Board is identified as an involved agency in accordance with SECRA for the purpose of assessing the effect of the zoning ordinance amendment on the environment and whether or not said effect is significant enough to warrant the preparation of a draft environmental impact statement. And whereas the town board has made a determination that they intend to act as a lead agency and will coordinate review with any other involved agencies with jurisdiction under SECRA and have prepared the required long environmental assessment form. Now therefore be it resolved that the town of Plattsburgh town board does hereby receive and place on file the draft former Clinton County Smart Growth Plan. And it's further resolved that the town board shall hold a public hearing in relation to the proposed amendment to the zoning ordinance at the town hall at 151 Vanderbilt, Plattsburgh, New York, 12901, on February 3rd, 2022 at 6:05 o'clock p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, and be it further resolved that pursuant to the provisions of Article 17, Section 17.4 of the town zoning ordinance, the town clerk shall cause a notice of the time and place of said public hearing to be published in the Press Republican, paper of general circulation in the town of Plattsburgh, at least 10 days before the February 3rd, 2022, with such notice also being posted on the town hall and given to necessary adjoining municipalities and the Clinton County Planning Board and such other agencies and parties as required by law. And be it further resolved that notice of said public hearings and a copy of the draft former Clinton County Airport Smart Growth Plan shall also be posted on the town's website. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution and attachments be given to the town clerk, planning department, zoning department, the adjacent municipalities, and Clinton County Planning Board and other interested agencies.
Is there a motion?
So moved.
Hebert, is there a second?
Second.
Isabella, any discussion? None. All is in favor, please say aye.
Can I have a roll call?
Sure. Roll call.
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Kostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yes.
And Michael Cashman?
Yes. Resolution passes. So a couple weeks we will have a public hearing on that. Knowing of the need to go into an executive session to discuss the work history of one specific individual with no actions to be taken, is there a motion to go into executive session?
So moved.
Kostick, is there a second?
Second.
Wood, can I get a roll call?
Thomas Wood?
Yes.
Barbara Hebert?
Yes.
Charles Kostick?
Yes.
Dana Isabella?
Yes.
And Mike Patrick?
Yes, we will officially go into executive session at 6:20. Again, no formal action to be taken.
Let me just gather my crap. Excuse me.
Is everybody registered for the closing of the town?